本实验的程序与 C6.1.13 相似。基础知识的学习可以参考之前的相关视频。This experiment is similar to C6.1.13. The fundamentals can be referred in previous tutorials. 程序里声明了指向麦克风信号输出端 A2 的变量 mic， 以及控制发光二极管的变量 LED。A variable mic is assigned by the microphone analog input pin A2. Another wearable LED controls the mouth LED. 在 loop 函数中，由 while 循环实现50毫秒内声音信号的采样。得到的采样值 peak to peak 由这50毫秒内的最大值和最小值之间的差值计算得到。In the loop function, the while loops in 50 milliseconds to sample the sound, which results a representative value peak to peak. For the 50 milliseconds by subtracting the maximum value by the minimum value. 接下来就用发光二极管的亮度来指示采样值的大小。也就是亮度指示声音的大小。 The following lines enable the LED brightness to indicate the sound level. 由于 peak to peak 是由 analog read 采样得到的，其范围与 analog read 的数值相似，即0至1023。 peak to peak 的数值越小，表明声音越小，发光二极管越暗。Peak to peak would have the same range as the function analog read, between 0 and 1023. The less the peak to peak, the lower the sound level, and the dimmer of the LED. 如果要用 PWM 信号让发光二极管亮度变化，使用的指令是 analog write。PWM 信号的参数范围为0至255，这个参数数值越小，发光二极管越亮；参数数值越大，发光二极管越暗。To vary the LED brightness, PWM signals generated by the function analog write are used. The value in analog write ranges from 0 to 255. The smaller the value,the brighter the LED, and vice versa. 所以我们需要用映射函数 map 把范围是0至1023的 peak to peak 重新映射到255到0范围上，再送给 analog write 去控制发光二极管的亮度。 It's reasonable to use the function mapto remap the peak-to-peak from 0 to 1023 to a new range from 255 to 0, and then use the new range as the analog write value. 以上的做法也是为了使两个不同范围的变量能更好的配合，充分利用 PWM 信号和发光二极管的完整亮度对声音信号的大小进行指示。The purpose of using the map function is to maximize the application of the PWM signals and the full range of the LED brightness to better display the sound levels.